All right. I was asked to do a video at Huntington Lake. So there is a sailboat race today. So I'm hoping I could catch some fish or have some fun before the boats start coming out here doing the races. So there's gonna be a race today, race tomorrow, and on the weekend. Today is a Thursday, and as of right now, it's nice and quiet, peaceful, and no wind. But since there's been a sailboat in a while, they're gonna try to get on the water by 11 o'clock. So by 11 o'clock, it will be windy. So I'm hoping to catch some fish. I don't really fish this lake too often, maybe once a year, maybe. I didn't fish it at all last year, but we'll see how it goes. Alright, got one hooked up 15 feet under the water. Let's see what it is. Bit pretty good. Man, this guy's quite good. Could it be a brown? Oh, that's a big brown. Woo! That's a big brown. Nice brown. Perfect. Oh shit. Oh man. That's a big brown. Woo. Beautiful brown. If I could take my lure off. Wow, that's a big brown. That's a big brown. Ay, ay, ay. Whoa, easy. I knew I lost one earlier. Reel this one in. It's like being in the ocean. Man. It's like the other day when I went salmon fishing half moon day. It's all rock. Just like this. Still don't need any fish. Looks like just all over there by the river neck, I guess. Or the river. Or the creek comes into the lake. And that's where I found most of the fish. A lot of fish over there. But I don't want to go over there because there's some bait fishing. A couple boats out there fishing. It just doesn't look like people sitting on the boat waiting to fish the bait. Kind of boring. I'd rather paddle around sightseeing. Although it would be nice if I got this wind, but it is what it is. Woo! Big wave. Whoa! perhaps see it. Sailboats are starting to come out zigzagging, trying to go out into the open water. Thought about coming back to this cove over here and fish behind me. But it looks like there's a lot of other boats over there trying to get out. To my left, your right. One more sailboat about ready to get out too. So I think I might call it a day early. Start heading back, going back towards the island. Kick back to the island for a little bit. There's a lot of boats all over the place. Little kids on little boats. Other little kids on other little boats. It's a lot of boat traffic. And the sailboats are still just coming out. Look at the sailboat. Turn to my right so you can see on my left, which is on your right. Look over there, all the sailboats are starting to come out. I really don't want to be in the way of the racing. And then there's another sailboat in front of me. I don't know if he's going straight or turning. So, shall be interesting. Alright, so one of you guys asked me what I was using as my stringer. And pretty much just a wrench clip. It's pretty much a put your wrench on it. So pretty much you open it up and stick out your wrench and hang on the wall. But as a kayak fisherman and ocean fisherman, usually most of the time you use a big old clip for lean cod and other rock fish. As for me, dog leash, this is nicer. You could adjust the length that you want your fish to be in the water. And plus, it has a little clip over here, so you twist and turn. That's a lot nicer. You could clip in your two bass on one of them, and then you could clip in your striper on the other two, or your trout. So when you do take it home, rather than taking the whole clip, the whole stringer, just unclip it and just take this clip with your trout. It's easier. And if you're hiking to a fishing spot, it's still nicer with this because you can hang your fish on here and just clip onto your backpack, lock it in, and you're good, set to go. But I like this setup. It works for me. To Eastern.